Assalamualaikum and hello everyone. How are you? I hope everyone is doing fine. My name is Miss Ain. Today, I'm not going into an actual teaching lesson, but this video would seem to be a fairly educational purpose. Please share this with all your friends that you think might benefit from this video. Well, this isn't a rant, but this is solely based on my opinion. This is regarding the use of English language, especially among us, the second language learners in Malaysia, where English isn't our first language or isn't our mother tongue. This is a general issue. I'm not pointing out anybody, all right? Personally, I, as an English teacher or a primary school English teacher, felt the need to touch on this issue. So first thing first, let me ask you a question. Are you afraid to speak in English? And why? Do let me know in the comment section below. I love to read your responses. Well, my English isn't perfect. It is flawed in so many ways. However, because I am an English teacher, I need to have an excellent command of English, perfect in the sense of pronunciation, the grammar use, and the vocabulary. So I keep on improving my language skill, as we, the English teachers, are perceived as the model of the language. But bear in mind that we are not native speakers. We are bound to make mistakes as well. What makes a difference is that we learn from mistakes. I would say one of the main reasons why our pupils, students, or even adults afraid to speak English in public, mainly because they're afraid people would judge them, condemn them, or ridicule, or mock. Right? Do you agree with that statement? Frankly speaking, I have that fear as well. But as time goes by, I tend to care less about that. I just have to accept that some people are judgmental. But there's always some people that will always support us. We just need to focus or prioritize those who support us. Surround ourselves with positive vibes, I would say. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. You have to bear in mind, yeah, boys and girls, that English isn't our first language. It might be a slip of the tongue, a grammar mistake here and there, but most importantly is that you learn from those mistakes. I always encourage my pupils, practice makes perfect. There will always be people around us that judge us or mock us or try to find fault. That's just how they are. Say this straight to their face. At least I'm trying, right? Nevertheless, when it comes to an actual presentation, speech, lecture, try your best to minimize errors. Practice comes beforehand. If there's still a bit of mistakes here and there, like mispronunciation, that is totally unavoidable, given that you have practiced or double-checked before. But that is not a ticket for others, netizens, to condemn or degrade those who are using the language, okay? As this might give a big impact on someone's self-confidence. The effect it has on the community is that younger generations or kids will totally avoid or reluctant to use the language simply because they are afraid to be condemned. What we can do is that when people are trying their level best to use the language, support them. Let's normalize Malaysians speaking English. Even though it's broken English, let's just support. It's free. We don't have to pay anything, right? And there's actually an art to correct people's mistakes, especially when using the language. Publicly shaming others is definitely not one of them. To end this video, I would like to educate others the art of correcting others' mistakes. First, start off with praising their effort. They need that confidence boost. Provide constructive criticism. For example, wow, your English is not bad. Very good, try. Wow, your English is good. Very good, try. Maybe next time, try to pronounce this word as such. Alright, correct their English in polite way. Sugarcoat them with phrases. Next, give them a model or examples. Actually, the pronunciation of the word doubt is doubt. The B is silent. Example, okay? Avoid sounding authoritative. Use gentle and helpful tone. Sometimes it may seem easy to all of you, but not to others. Make sure your correction is educational. Bukan nak hentam saja, okay? And last but not least, and I believe this is most important, important is that do this in private. Nobody likes to be in the spotlight when it comes to making mistakes. If you really feel the need to say it out loud in a public setting, make sure your advice is general enough that nobody is thinking of that one particular person when you mention such mistake. Okay, you know what I mean, right? I think that is all for now. Thank you so much for listening till the last bit. Remember, practice makes perfect. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. It is a part of learning process. Before we end the video, if you like this kind of talk, if you like my videos, please do subscribe to my channel. Call me Miss Ain. And yeah, I think that is all for now. Assalamualaikum and goodbye.